हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द फिफ्थ एंड द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल्स। दिस एक्सरसाइज ऑल्सो डील्स विद द फैक्टराइजेशन, बट फैक्टराइजेशन यूजिंग सम इम्पॉर्टेंट आइडेंटिटीज। सो लेट अस नोट डाउन द आइडेंटिटीज फर्स्ट। इम्पॉर्टेंट आइडेंटिटीज, सो द फर्स्ट आइडेंटिटी वी हैव इज x plus y whole square. What will be its expansion? X square plus y square plus 2xy. You have to memorize all this identity by heart, write each identity, speak and write at least 50 times, right? Then the second one, we have x minus y whole square, that is x square plus y square minus 2xy. Then the third one, we have x square minus y square, so it will be x plus y into x minus y. Fourth identity, we have x plus a into x plus b, that is x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Then the fifth identity we have is x plus y plus z whole square, so its expansion will be a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2yz plus 2zx. Then the sixth one you have is x plus y whole cube. Its expansion will be a cube plus b cube, x cube plus y cube plus 3xy bracket x plus y. Then seventh one we have is x minus y whole cube. Its expansion will be a cube minus x cube minus y cube minus 3xy bracket x minus y. And then the last one we have is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz will be equal to x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx, right? So these are the identities based on which we have so many questions in the exercise. So let us start with the questions in the exercise number 2.5, how to use these identities to factorize, right? So the first question, we have is x plus 8 x minus 10. We have x plus 8, right, x minus 10. Then we have to again use identity to find this product. So which identity we will use? We will use the identity fourth one, right, x plus a x plus b. Now in place of b we have minus 10, so you should note down here a is 8 and b is minus 10. And then write down using x plus a x plus b, x square plus a plus b into x plus ab, right? You should always write down the formulas, that creates a good impression. So the product of x plus 8 into x minus 10 will be equal to x square plus a plus b, right, a plus b into x plus ab. So x square, 8 minus 10 is minus 2x, and this will give me minus 80. So this is the answer. Simple? Yes, very simple. Then the second question we have is evaluate 95 into 96. Again we have to do this evaluation using some identity. So which identity you will use? This does not resembles any of the identity, so what to do here? You will do the conversion into one of the formats. So what type of conversion you will use? I can write down 95 as 90 plus 5, 96 can be written as 90 plus 6, right? I have adjusted this product in this format. Now this resembles which identity? Fourth one, right? So write down here using x plus a x plus b is equals to x square plus a plus b into x plus AB, right? What is x here? X is 90, A is 5 and B is 6, right? So let us do it. So 90 square plus 5 plus 6, right? 5 plus 6, x, so x is 90, plus AB, so 5 into 6. So this will give me 8100 plus 11. 11 into 90 is 990 plus 30. Now let us add all of them. So 8100, 990 and 30. So this will give me 9120, right? So this is the answer we have. Now let us look at the third question, right? Third question says factorize using the identity. So factorize 4y square minus 4y plus 1. So which identity you will use here to factorize? So this looks like this second identity, right? So let us try to convert in that format. First we will write down the identity using x minus y whole square, x square plus y square minus 2xy, right? So this first term 4y square, 4y can be written as 2y whole square. Then this one minus 2 into 2y, correct? And the last one is 1 square. So this is 2x, right? 2 into x into y. Here y will be 1. So this can be now summarized as 2y minus 1 whole square. So that is the factorization of this. Even if you open this using that identity, you will again get this answer. That is the way to verify it, right? Let us look at this once again. How to factorize this? To factorize this, we are using this identity. Now you have to identify x square. X square means the first term. This one you convert into whole square. So to convert this into whole square, I have written it in this format. Then this is 2xy, so convert it into 2xy, so 2xy, and then finally the y square, right? Let us look at the fourth question now. So the fourth question says expand using the suitable identities 2x minus y plus z whole square. Again we have to do the expansion using the identity. Which identity you will use? Only one identity is like this, so that is this identity. So we'll again mention here using x plus y plus z whole square, x square y square z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx, right? So as per the question, what is x? In place of x we have 2x, right? And in place of y we have minus y. And in place of z, we have z. So please notice this. So now we will use x square. So but in place of x, question has 2x. So we'll write down 2x square plus in place of y, we have minus y. So minus y square, z is as it is. So z square plus 2. X is 2x, y is minus y plus 2yz. So 2. Y is minus y, z is as it is, and 2 times z, and in place of x what will come? 2x, right? Simplify this. 4x square plus y square plus z square plus 2 twos are 4, minus into plus is minus, so minus 4xy, then this will be again minus into plus minus, so minus 2yz, and this will make 4zx, so plus 4zx. This is the answer for the fourth question, right? Just we are using the identity to make the expansion. Let us look at the fifth question. So what is the fifth question? Factorize, right? Factorize. The question is 2x square plus y square plus 8z square minus 2 root 2xy प्लस 4√2 yz माइनस 8xz, राइट। सो अगेन दिस इज नथिंग बट दिस वी हैव टू फैक्टराइज। वॉट टाइप ऑफ आइडेंटिटी वी विल यूज हियर? द फिफ्थ आइडेंटिटी, राइट। सो वी कैन राइट डाउन अगेन आइडेंटिटी। सो यूजिंग फिफ्थ आइडेंटिटी, सो लेट अस कन्वर्ट इट इन टू द फॉर्मैट। टू कैन बी रिटन एज √2x² देन y² एज इट इज। दिस वन कैन बी रिटन एज 8, कैन बी रिटन एज 2√2, बिकॉज इफ यू स्क्वेयर दिस नंबर अगेन यू विल गेट 8। सो सिंस वी हैव टू कन्वर्ट इन टू द स्क्वेयर फॉर्मैट, होल स्क्वेयर फॉर्मैट, वी हैव कन्वर्टेड 8 दिस वे, 2√2z², राइट। देन द अदर टर्म्स विल बी एज इट इज, 2√2xy, then 4√2yz and minus 8xz. Now see, in place of x we have √2x. So here also if we compare it with the identity, right, 2xy, so here also we have 2, right, this is the 2, then this is our x, √2x. See, this is our x term. And y, if you see here yz, then y it is as it is, right. Then 4 can be written as 2 into 2√2z.y. So see, again it is in the 2yz format. In place of z we have this whole number, so 2yz format. And 8xz, now x and z if you multiply, what we should get? Let us do it in rough first. So this is the x term and this is the z term. If you multiply this, √2 × √2 is 2, 2 into 2 is 4. So 4xz we get. So that is what it is written here, 2 into 4xz, right? So this given expression, it can be clearly written as √2x plus y plus 2√2z whole square, right? This is the answer. Next, we have question number 6. Right, sixth question, write the following cubes in expanded form. So we have to expand this. Which identity you will use? A minus b whole, x minus y whole cube, right, x minus y whole cube. So we will write down here using x minus y whole cube. What is the expansion? A cube minus b cube minus 3xy bracket x minus y, right. So same way here it will be a cube, right. If we apply this identity here, it will be x cube, then y cube, right, x cube y cube minus 3x in place of y, right. So and x minus y, so 2a minus 3b. Simplify, 8a cube minus 27b cube minus 3 × 3 = 9, 9 × 2 = 18, 18ab and 2a minus 3b. You should take multiple steps, don't hurry in solving the questions. If you skip any of the steps, you will make mistake. ab². So this is the solution to the sixth question. Simple. Then seventh question, it says that use identity to carry out the following evaluation. So this one we have to evaluate using identity. So which identity you will use? This 100, it can be written as 100 plus 2 whole cube, right. So this is equal to the sixth identity. So what is the sixth identity? A x cube plus y cube plus 3xy bracket x plus y. What is the 100 cube? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros, right? 2 cube, 8 plus, this will be 600, 100 plus 2. Do the expansion. This is 3, this is 10 lakh. So 10 lakh plus 8 plus this will be 60,000 plus 1200. Do all this addition. So if you carry out the addition, you should do it in the rough so that you don't make any mistake. 0 0 0 0 0 0, right? And then we have 1200. So 0 0 2 1. So 80216. So 10,61,208. This is the expansion of 102 whole cube. Then the eighth question, it says factorize. Question number 8, it is again factorize. So what does the question is 27 minus 125 a cube minus 135 a, right, plus 225 a square. Yes, so if you convert it, this 27 can be written as 3 cube, this can be written as 5a cube, right? So since this is a minus b, x minus y format, this will be, from these two you take out a common, then what else thing you can take out? You can take out 3 common and also you can take out 5a common. So what will remain in the bracket? Since 15a is outside, what it will remain here? Nine, right? Here remains 9. Here remains the 9, and what will remain here? 15a, right? So just see here, a cube minus b cube minus 3ab, bracket, it should give me a plus b. This will be equal to the expansion of a cube minus b cube, a cube minus b cube, right, minus 3xy. So minus 3x and some one more 3 we can take out common from here. So 3, this is x, this is y, right, x y. So this is our x, this is our y, 3xy, right? We are arranging it in the format of x cube minus y cube minus 3xy, bracket, x minus y. So here it will be, we have taken another 3 common, so remaining is 3 and 5a. So this can be now written as 3 minus 5a whole cube. That is the answer for this. This we have now factorized using the identity, right? Then the ninth question, it says verify x cube plus y cube is equals to x plus y, x square minus xy plus y square. How do we verify this? So let us start its verification, right? We have this identity x plus y whole cube, right? Which one? Sixth number. Its expansion is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab, 3xy, bracket, x plus y. Shifting this part on the left hand side, so left hand side will now become minus 3xy, x plus y is equals to x cube plus y cube, correct? Now from these two terms, I can take out x plus y common, yes. So remaining will be x plus y square, and here it will remain minus 3xy. So x cube plus y cube. Now let me expand this. Let me expand x plus y whole square. Expansion will be a square plus b square plus 2xy, then this minus 3xy, right? If I further simplify, this will give me x square plus y square minus xy, right? Hence, we have proved it, right? Hence, we can write down here, hence, verify. Based on this same expansion, based on this expansion, we have a question number 10. What is the question number 10? Factorize. Factorize 27y cube minus plus 125 z cube. Right? Hello. So this is a cube. This I can write it as x cube plus. This is 125, so 5z, right? X cube plus y cube. What is the expansion of x cube plus y cube? We have already proved. So this can be written as x plus y into x square minus xy. So x y plus y square. See, exactly as per this expansion we have done, x plus y, then x square, then minus xy, then y square. Let us simplify this. 3y plus 5z, 9y square minus 15yz plus 25z square, right? Can we factorize it further? Yes, this can be further factorized. Is it possible? Not possible. So this is the factorization for this question. Next we have question number 11. What does it say? Factorize 27x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 9xyz. How will you do factorization? Which identity you will use? This identity, 8th identity, right? So what will be the factorization for this? First we have to identify what is x, y and z. So my x will be, this is the, so x will be 3x, right? Here the value of x will be 3x, y is as it is, z is also as it is. So let us start with the expansion. First is x. So instead of x, I will write down 3x, then y is y and then z, right? Then x square means 3x square, then plus y square plus z square minus x into y, right? X into y minus yz minus z into x. So let us simplify further. So 3x plus y plus z, this will be 9x square plus y square plus z square minus 3xy minus yz minus 3xz. This is the answer. Then 12th question. Question number 12 is verify. 12th question it is says verify. What we have to verify? X cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equals to half of x plus y plus z bracket, then we have x minus y whole square, right? Then plus y minus z whole square plus y minus z whole square and then z minus x whole square. How to do this? So it is again very easy. Let us take left hand side of the equation. This equation, x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz, right? How this can be written as per this? So let us write down. So x plus y plus z, then x square plus y square plus z square, I'll use square bracket, then minus xy minus yz minus zx, correct? Now what I will do, since I see half here, so I will multiply and divide by 2, right? Half will remain as it is, this 2 will be multiplied inside. So x plus y plus z, and if I multiply 2 inside, with every term 2 will be multiplied, right? So it will become 2x square plus 2y square plus 2z square minus 2xy minus 2yz minus 2zx, right? Let us rearrange. So half of x plus y plus z, this can be written as x square plus x square, right? So I will write down x square. First I want x minus y whole square. So x square, then out of y, 2y square, I will use 1y square. Then y square plus z square, then z square plus x square. See, 2x square is splitted into x square, y square is splitted into y square, 2z square is splitted into z square. You should now understand that this I will arrange with these terms to make as this property or this identity. So now minus 2xy, minus 2yz, minus 2zx, right? Then half of x plus y plus z, x square plus y square, minus 2xy I will bring here together, then plus y square plus z square, and then minus 2yz I will bring together, plus z square plus x square, then minus 2zx. It is very long. So now it is done. X plus y plus z, this will give me x minus y whole square, plus this is y minus z whole square, plus this is z minus x whole square. That is what I was asked to prove, correct? Let us see once again. This is the question given and I have to verify this. So taking the left hand side of the equation, I use identity 8. So as per identity 8, this polynomial can be written in this format. Now I can see that on right hand side I have half. How to get half? So I just simply multiplied by and divided by the 2. The division 2 remains as it is. Multiplication 2 is multiplied with this bracket. So it becomes 2 times. Now this x square, 2x square, it is separated. This 2y square, it is separated. 2z square, it is separated. Separation must be done as per the required right hand side. After doing separation, I did rearrangement and hence I got the right hand side. Next, we have question number 13. Question number 13 says that if x plus y plus z is equals to 0, show that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equals to 3xyz. How to do this? So I have to use identity, right? Which identity I will use? Again, 8th identity. So what does that identity says? So using identity 8, you should write down the full identity here. So using that identity and substituting, I will substitute this equation x plus y plus z equal to 0. So what this identity will become? X cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz equal to, now this is 0. So 0 multiplied by something is 0. So now I have got the proof, 3xyz, right? So I can write down that, hence verified, or you can say hence showed. Simple. Then next question we have, 14th question. It says that without actually calculating the cube, find the value of minus 12 cube plus 7 cube and plus 5 cube without using the cube. So here I can see that x is minus 12, y is 7 and z is 5. If I calculate x plus y plus z, I will get 0, because minus 12 plus 7 plus 5 will give me 0. Since x, y, z is 0, I can use this identity. So minus 12 cube plus 7 cube plus 5 cube will be equal to 3 into minus 12 into y, value of y is 7 and value of z is 5. So let us multiply. 7 5s are 35, 35 into 3, 105 and 105 into 12, 1260. So minus 1260 is the answer for this expansion, right? Then 15th question. 15th question says that for the possible expression, we have to find out length and breadth, and we have been given that area is equals to 35 square plus 13y minus 12. So what to do? Area is given to us and length and breadth are to be identified. So this question is nothing but factorization, right? So let us try to factorize this. So 35y square plus 13y minus 12. How will you factorize this? This cannot be converted into any of the identity format. So what to do? So let us use our factorization method. What is the name of that method? Factorization method we will use, which is called as a splitting method. So as per the splitting method, first we will find out AC. Step one, we will find out AC. So let me find out AC. The value of AC is 420. In second step, I am asked to find out the factors of 420. So let me find out the factors of 420, right? Then these are the factors. What are the possible combinations? 2 into 2 3s are 6, 6 5s are 30, 37s are 210. Then other combination is 4 into 3 5s are 15, 15 7s are 105, right? So 4 into 105, then 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, into 7 5s are 35, correct? I think then what will come? Which one will be suitable? I can write down one more. 2 2s are 4, 4 5s are 20. Right, 2 2s are 4, 4 5s are 20, and 20 into 21. This will also give me 420. So this combination is suitable. 2 2s are 4, 4 5s are 20, 20 and 21, no. This also not suitable. Let me write down some more. I want 13. The addition or subtraction must give me 13. So that way I have to arrange them. So 2 2s are 4, 4 7s are 28, and 5 3s are 15. So will this give me 13? Yes. So the subtraction of this will give me 13. This is all rough work. You don't have to show in the solution. But just for you to recollect the splitting method, I am doing the steps. So 28 and 15, right? So let me rearrange. Now I will skip some steps. So plus 28y. Since there is a plus sign here, I will use plus sign with the bigger number. Minus 15y minus 12. So this will be 7 can be common from these two terms, right? 7y. So 5y plus 4 and minus 3 common. So 5y plus 4. Again, 5y plus 4 into 7y minus 3. Hence, I will write down my answer that length will be equal to 5y plus 4 and breadth will be equal to 7y minus 3, or length will be equal to 7y minus 3 and breadth will be equal to 5y plus 4, right? So similarly, you can solve question number 16 also. If you don't get, you can comment it as a doubt. See you in the next chapter.